Hi everyone and happy Monday. Welcome from a very hot sunny Southern California. It is hot. It's probably in the 90s right now and we're expecting probably close to triple digits for the rest of the week. So I'm out here sweating away, but having a great time. We're here with you on a Monday and we're dealing with the topic today of garden burnout. So if you're one of those that sometimes feels like quitting your garden here in August, if you just feel burned out and not like really doing anything outside, you're not alone and you're definitely in the right place. Lots of support and encouragement in the chat today. And I'm gonna talk about some things that I do to help deal with that and help avoid it if at all possible, because yes, I deal with it too. So, you know, let's just get real here and put it out there. We had a poll earlier in the live stream. In fact, I think it's still up there in the chat. And it says that 53% of you are dealing with garden burnout and the other 46% are not. So it's a little bit more than half. So I think it's a really appropriate topic for today. But before we jump into that, let me just say hello to those of you that are here in the chat. V is here, it's cool there in Texas. From a 99 down from 103 to 105. So it feels like you're having a cold spell right there, V. Rocky, hi, how are you doing? Sadly, the lack of rain is not helping. I totally agree with you on that one. Right here with you here in Southern California on that one too. M says this year's hot sun is the worst in SoCal history. Yeah, it's definitely pretty toasty. Garib at Gorba, my tomatoes heirloom aren't ripening. Any tips? Ask me later in the live stream if I forget to answer that one, and we'll try and answer that one a little bit. Charlene is here. She's from Spain. Let's see. Ruth Ann, no burnout here in Southern Maine. I'll just take the summer, all the summer I can get. Well, that's wonderful. I'm sure you're enjoying the warm weather there, because I know your winters are pretty severe, so hopefully you're really enjoying the warmth. 808 Ladybug, I had success with Japanese cukes and pickling ones this year. That's so much fun. The cucumbers are rolling in. Some people are having a tough time with cucumbers, but I'm glad yours are doing well, 808. Ramona, the mosquitoes are killing me. That's crazy. So you have to let me know how you deal with those. We haven't had much mosquitoes here this year in our area, but I know some places in Southern California are dealing with it, and definitely more in humid climates. Pete Treadway from Arizona is here. Jill Goodman, the Hillingberry from Germany. Santa Ana Road Wildman, he gets to join us here on his day off. Always fun to see him here in the live stream. So great to have you. And let me see if there's anyone else we can say hello to before we move on here to our topic. Oh,
here's your drink.
Camera guy. Thank you. Oh, okay. My goodness.
All right. Good to have you here.
What? Welcome. A sweetheart.
Okay. If there's anything else you need, just let us know.
Aw, okay. Thank you, honey. And camera guy is here bringing me a nice cold glass of sparkling water. So that's really nice of him. So before we jump into our tips, I'm going to take a little swig and maybe camera guy will come back and say hello a little bit later in the live stream. So let us know in the chat if you'd like him to come back on, and I'm sure that he would come back out and say hello. Oh, that tastes so good. Speaking of camera guy, he's doing some random Instagram live streams. You've got to follow him on Instagram. He's doing a lot of behind the scenes posting. His Instagram handle is Kelly Camera Guy. And yesterday he did an impromptu live stream early Sunday morning because we were trying to catch some of the people that were in international areas. Germany, Spain, people in Europe, where there's like an 8 or 9 hour time difference. So we did have some international viewers on. The Hillingberry, Charlene Mitchell was on. And our very own Cliff, who is not international, but he's in Idaho, was able to jump on and show us his garden there in Idaho and show us his giant pumpkin. So do stay tuned for some of those little behind the scenes Instagram lives. And maybe you'll be able to jump on and show us your garden too. Okay, so let's jump in. Yeah, we love seeing Cliff's pumpkin. He said he hasn't measured it yet, but I don't know. He's going for 1,000 pounds. His record at one point in time was 900 and something. So do head over for his Instagram, to his Instagram at Cliff R. Warren, and check things out over there, and maybe you'll see a picture. But it was quite impressive. So Cliff, great job. Okay, I'm gonna grab my notes here. We're gonna jump into our first Not really a tip, but kind of talking about burnout just a little bit. What is it? Some signs and symptoms. Well, first off, I know a lot of us here, and hands up in the chat if this is you, have had a tough summer. It has been hot almost everywhere. Even like Healingberry was saying, in Germany, it's 80 degrees Fahrenheit, which is pretty hot for them there. It would feel really nice to us here, but when you're not used to that higher temperature in the summertime and your plants aren't used to it, you're not acclimated to that, and maybe you don't have air conditioning because you're not used to it getting that hot, then it can really be a hardship. But I know a lot of areas are getting triple digits all summer, even way up into the triple digits, like 107, 110, that don't normally always feel that. I know the Pacific Northwest has been hot. Northern California has been crazy. We actually haven't been too bad here in SoCal, but we are hitting our warm time of year. August, September, October is usually when we get hit with triple digits, and definitely the heat is coming. But not only that, here in August, a lot of times, you know, the pests and the diseases just come creeping in along with the heat. And you can just get kind of weary and tired of dealing with all of these challenges all at once. You might feel overwhelmed. You might just not feel like getting out in the garden anymore, whereas in the spring you are raring to go. So normal garden tasks might just seem a little bit overwhelming and might just feel like a chore. That's definitely a sign of burnout. Maybe you're struggling with motivation. Maybe you don't want to plant your fall garden at all. Maybe you are just procrastinating taking care of your garden, and your garden is really feeling the impact. Things are getting overgrown, things are getting toasted and dying, and you don't even go out maybe to harvest perhaps, and your vegetables are getting overgrown. I know that's easy to happen when you get busy, but when you get burnt out and just don't want to get outside, sometimes that happens as well. So maybe you're just kind of feeling anxious and stressed and overwhelmed in general about everything that's going on outside. So if that's you, you're in good company here, because according to our poll, 53% now are feeling that same way. And that's what we're here for. We're here to provide support, encouragement, ideas, and ways that we can deal with burnout. Because sometimes you just need a little bit of boost of encouragement, just a little something to help you, you know, a little inspiration to help you keep on growing throughout the fall and winter. So here we are to provide that. And I know a lot of people will provide that in the chat as well. So the first thing that I like to do, because I always get burned out this time of the year too, is I really try and focus more on enjoyment, not just the tasks that need to be done day to day. So, you know, this would include things like maybe just taking a short little break from your garden to recharge. Sometimes, you know, we just need to get away for a day or two, or even just, you know, take a break from the garden for a day or two and focus on another project in another area of your life that you'd like to work on. Spend some time with friends and family, maybe that you've been too busy to do, but just take a little break. Nothing wrong with that. And again, if you are feeling burnt out, there's nothing wrong with you. It's very normal. So take a break, step away for a little bit, kind of get a new perspective on things. And then once you're recharged and refreshed, you'll feel more like coming back to it. One thing I like to do, especially when I'm feeling burnt out, is really just kind of enjoy the time in the garden. So take coffee walks. I remember when I used to do some videos on that, maybe I'll have to get back to that. But grab your cup of coffee early in the morning before it gets too hot, and get out there and just walk around your garden and enjoy it. You know, don't take any pruners or little shovels or anything with you. Just walk around, look at your plants, look at the flowers, enjoy the nature around you. In the morning is such a beautiful time because there's butterflies, there's bees, the birds are out. Maybe you see, like in our yard, we see tons and tons of lizards, which are always kind of fun to see. Mac likes to come out and just kind of sit down and sit in your favorite spot in the garden. Look around and just enjoy and appreciate nature and the beauty that you've created. Try to look past the burnt out plants. Try and look past maybe the tomato that's got eaten by a rat, and just revel in the fact that it's such a blessing to even be able to grow our own food. Maybe you didn't used to even know how to do that, and take stock of the blessings and just be thankful in what you've learned this year. Be thankful for your harvests. Even if they're small, it's still more than you would harvest if you weren't growing anything at all. So really just focus on what you're thankful for. sit and enjoy. And really, once you do that, you just have a little bit of time to reflect. Hopefully that will recharge you as well. You might even want to take a little break just to do some reading, do some research, maybe on a topic that you would like to maybe grow and learn. Maybe you want to grow a fall garden and you could look up, you know, what are good seeds to plant for fall. Maybe you're dealing with, aphids, I think someone said. And maybe you want to look up how to deal with aphids in your garden and do a little bit of research. Or just look up something fun like a flower that you'd want to plant. Look up a blog and read a couple of fun blog articles. Or maybe sit out there and do some shopping. Who knows? Whatever helps you feel refreshed and recharged. Just take some time away to do that. And before you know it, you're focusing more on enjoyment than the tasks. You'll be recharged and ready to go back. So I think the whole point here is just to make a conscious choice. You know, not to spiral down in the burnout and just quit and just give up, because you might feel like doing that. But make a conscious choice to do some of these things we're going to talk about today so you can keep yourself going and really fill yourself back up so that you can then give to other people. Okay, so we're going to come back in a moment for another tip, but before I do that, let's head into the chat and see what little tips and tricks you all have here on dealing with garden burnout, or what you're doing to avoid it in your life, or maybe if you're not burned out, what you can do to encourage someone else. Okay, let's see here. I love this one. Sobal, great suggestion. Invite friends and family to harvest with you and take off some of the load. And that actually will lead into our next tip. So we'll talk about that in just a moment. That's a great idea. And a lot of times when you see someone else come in and help you out, or just come in and harvest, then you get excited again because they're excited. So I'm going to tell you a story about that. On Friday, we had the privilege of, I met a wonderful woman at Freetown Farm out in Maryland when we were out there in June, named Erica. She helps out at the farm and volunteers. She works with Gary a lot at Freetown Farm. And she was out here visiting her best friend, who had never ever grown anything before, but just moved into a new house. So she asked if she could come visit and take her friend for a tour around the garden. I said, of course, bring her over. And they toured the garden, and she brought her 12-year-old son. I had tons of stuff to harvest. And I just gave them a harvest basket. And as we walked around, I said, go at it. Pick a zucchini, pick a scallop squash, pick some herbs. And they left with a huge, huge box of produce. And I can't tell you how excited she was to see things growing, how it inspired her to garden. And it really was a big inspiration and motivation for me too, that wow, some people have never seen how zucchini grows, and she was able to pick and harvest all kinds of things, and it motivated and encouraged me to just keep on growing and keep on sharing what I love to do. So maybe that's you, and you can invite someone over to harvest some vegetables and then take them home and enjoy them on their own. Okay, yes, they were very, very motivated, Charlene, and it was really, really fun to see their excitement and their joy and how inspiring they were. So that was awesome. Root trackers, I love this. I do that often. Yesterday, I walked around and talked to my plant. That's a great idea. Our plants need encouragement too. And you know what? There's something about the energy that you get from plants. The green is just therapeutic and refreshing. And if you can at all do that, create a little space in your garden, as we did with our chill zone too, where you can just sit and relax at the end of the day and really just appreciate and enjoy the beauty that you've created. Carl, thank you so much. Love your channel, Callie Kim. Glad that you're here. Hope it provides you some great tips and inspiration, and I appreciate your encouragement and your kind words. Drink some moonshine. Hey, if that helps, hey, go for it, right? A little glass of moonshine out in the garden in the evening might give you that little boost that you need. Dark FF, will cucumbers grow at this time of summer? Okay, if you have about 6 to 8 weeks of warm weather left, yes, you can definitely still get some cucumbers planted. So now's a great time to kind of, you know, pull out some plants that are struggling and plant some new ones. In the warm temperatures, they'll grow very, very fast. But again, you do need about 6 to 8 weeks of warm temps to get a harvest. I do have a special seed collection just for that, of quick growing veggies. It's called the Late Summer Garden Seed Collection. So if you don't have one of these, it's a good one to grow this time of year to pop in your garden so you have some fresh new plants. So great question. Okay, let's move on to the next tip. And we kind of, oh, before I forget, guys, we're just a few weeks away from Labor Day, crazy enough. I just wanted to mention now that we're not going to have a live stream on Labor Day. I believe the date is September 5th. So mark your calendars for that, just in case you show up. There's not going to be anyone here. And enjoy your day with your family, okay? Now, second tip is, and someone already alluded to this, is feeling burned out is a great time to ask for help. Maybe you're just like kind of to the end of your rope. So enlist the help. Don't be afraid to ask friends, family, neighbors. Maybe you can find someone who, again, is either brand new to gardening or someone who really enjoys gardening and maybe don't have the space to garden, or maybe just a friend. You can get together and go back and forth to each other's gardens, because let's face it, it's always a lot more fun when you're gardening with someone else. You can talk and have fun when you're gardening, and there's just something a little bit more motivating, like, okay, come on over to my house at 8 a.m. or 7:30, however early. Let's get out and weed out a garden bed or pull out some old plants and plant some new ones, and then I'll come to your house in the evening after it cools down, and we can do the same in your house. And you know, how much more fun would that be? In fact, my neighbor is a avid gardener as well, and we're both growing different kinds of squash. So whenever I pick a whole bunch of squash, I ask her if she wants some, and she asks me if I want some, but we're kind of growing the same kinds this year. So we're deciding next year we need to grow different things so that we have different things we can trade back and forth instead of both having an abundance of squash, cucumbers, and eggplant. So it's kind of a good strategy if you live next to someone or have a friend that you enjoy gardening with too, is ask for help. And the cool thing is, as you're gardening, you can share tips that work for each other. I mean, gardeners are just some of the nicest people in the world. I've always found them just so willing to share, so willing to encourage, so willing to support, and just really uplifting each other. So definitely see if you can find a garden buddy somewhere. If you don't have a garden buddy, maybe you can enlist the help of your kids. If they're young enough, they might be willing to get out there. If they're teenagers, it might be a little bit more tough to get them out there in the garden, or your partner. But see if you can find someone to garden with. If you don't have anyone nearby, then join a garden community of some kind, either online, like here, the chat, and the people in the chat. Some people have been here for years, like 3 or 4 years, and have gotten to be friends. No matter what country they live in, you know, they're chatting back and forth, or I see people talking on Instagram. Also, community gardening is a great way to go. You can get a plot at a local community garden and get to know some fellow gardeners that way. Okay, and the other thing is just bite off a little chunk at a time. So, you know, get your friend over and don't focus on the whole garden. Maybe just focus on one garden bed or just a couple of containers. And before you know it, by the end of the week, doing a little bit each day, you'll have a lot done and you won't feel so overwhelmed. Okay, back into the chat here, and let's see if there's any questions. Guadalupe, great to have you on here today. Thank you so much for hanging out. And I like her suggestion is, my husband and daughter have helped me water and clean up the garden this year. The heat has been brutal and the help is so appreciated. Okay, it's wonderful when the family can come together and help you out. And it's just something about having someone out there with you that just helps ease that feeling of overwhelm. Even if they're just outside with you and doing a few small garden tasks, it's just so encouraging. So I'm really glad that they've come out to help you. Okay, Angela. Hi, Angela. How are you? We got to meet Angela when we were out in Maryland. Have pull up some of my old summer plants that are now dying off. So yeah, Angela, great point is sometimes it's just easier to pull those out. You can work really hard with struggling plants sometimes, and they're just not going to revive. So it's a great time to pull some of those old out, even leave empty spaces for fall gardening, for your fall gardens, or pop in some quick growing vegetables that will mature before the weather gets too cold. Too hot. No, too cold, sorry. Like, it's getting very hot out here. So, okay. Let's see here. Let me scroll through the chat. A couple more times here. A lot of people pulling out some older cukes. Let me see if there's any questions. Corinne, no way. I feel like I'm just getting started. I have my first watermelon celebrity appearance. Oh, that's great. That's awesome. If you're not feeling burned out, that's great. Just keep on going and keep on growing and enjoy the bounty while you can, right? Okay, next tip, number 3. Okay, first off, we had focus on enjoyment, not tasks. Number 2, ask for help. Number 3 is keep it simple. Okay, when you're feeling overwhelmed, it's not the time to, you know, maybe build new raised beds or plant out 3 or 4 brand new raised beds. Just keep it simple and stick to the basics, okay? So downsize if you need to. If you just feel like you can't manage everything that you planted, because sometimes when we start out in the spring, our gardening eyes are bigger than what we actually have time to manage. And we might have planted, you know, way more than we could actually handle. And you know what? That's okay. That's all part of learning. But if you've read my first book, you know that my garden motto is start simple, expand later. But sometimes you might need to downsize just a little bit to keep it manageable so you don't get totally overwhelmed and completely quit. So don't feel bad if that's you and if that's something that you need to do. Maybe just stick to a couple of containers for now, or maybe just really focus on one raised bed and make sure you get the plants in that raised bed really growing well, and don't feel guilty about it. Just cut yourself some slack, right? It's okay. It's not a race. It's not a competition. It's just all about enjoying it. And if you're not enjoying it, then you need to do what you need to get back to that enjoyment level, and that's perfectly okay. Now, something that's kind of fun too is to kind of switch it up a little bit, right? A lot of us have been growing the same vegetables since like February or March when we might have started indoors. We planted those out, and you know, maybe you've had your fill of tomatoes and cucumbers and squash. Maybe you haven't yet, but if you have, switch it up a little bit, plant something new. Now is a great time for most gardeners, aside from maybe us southern gardeners here, to get your cool weather seeds started. And there's something about a new routine, at least for me anyway, I like a little bit of change every now and then. There's something about a new routine or new fresh plants that's exciting, gives you a little boost of energy, a little inspiration. So get some of those cool weather veggies started. Now's a great time. I've had lots of people ask me, when do I start gardening for fall? So a few weeks ago, we posted a video on that, which kind of gives some guidelines of a good time to start. But for most gardeners, now is the time to start your fall seeds. And if it's too hot where you live, no worries about it. You can start them indoors under grow lights. Dig your grow lights out again. You might have put them away for the summer, but dig them out. Just plant a couple of small little trays of seedlings. And believe me, it's going to be so fun to see them sprout, to see new life come back into the garden. And, you know, they'll grow inside for about 6 weeks or so. And that way, when you have some time, or when the weather cools off for most people in, say, September, October, you're going to have some beautiful transplants that you can then pop outside in the garden. And you're going to save yourself some time. So kind of mix it up a little bit, change your routine. I do have some cool weather veggies going inside, even though it's still a little bit hot here. But I like to plant them to encourage you all to get them going. And this tray, my cool weather veggies inside are actually getting a little bit overheated, even indoors. But these look really good here, these lettuce. And I think this is this is kohlrabi, the purple kohlrabi. But this lettuce, doesn't this look pretty? Now, we haven't seen lettuce outside for quite some time because it's way too hot. So it really was a nice little boost to see these growing indoors. This is the Grand Rapids lettuce. It's from my fall garden seed collection. So get some going. You could even put them in a larger type of container, like the Calichem 5-gallon, and have some inside. And that'll just kind of shake things up a little bit. Keep it simple like that. But if you don't have a fall garden seed collection, you can grab them over on my website. The sale this weekend is for 20%. So it's still a really good discount with the code GARDENFRESH. Grab those. Today is the last day of the sale. And I don't know if I have one with me here. Oh, here's one of them. You're also going to get one of my bookmarks from one of my books with your order. So you get the seeds, you get a free lettuce packet, and the seeds you have to purchase, but you get a free lettuce packet and a free bookmark with your order. So grab those today. But it really is a good time to either get your late summer seeds started, your fall garden, or even your cool weather flowers going. Now, I know it might seem a little early for that, but there's nothing like color to boost your mood. So you can get those cool season, the pollinator cool season flower seed collection going too. And that way you're going to have some transplants to pop in your garden soon. And that'll really make you feel good and give yourself a little bit of a lift. The other thing I was going to say is you might want to move a couple of garden beds or containers near your house. So you can just pop outside. Behind me here, it's just a little container of herbs. It's basil, purple basil, and some Italian large leaf basil. And I can just pop out here to the deck. I usually move it into the shade when it's really sunny, but I put it on right here behind me so you guys could see it. It's so easy to grow in a little 5-gallon container. And the great thing about that is, as soon as the weather is too cold for it, you could even move it indoors and then grow it inside for the winter time. One of my favorite ways to keep it simple and stick to the basics is just to grow in these little 1-gallon calochem pots. And just grow some herbs. These are chives. So these actually have been growing outside, but I can easily move them indoors, you know, whenever I want to, just to have some chives on my countertop. So, you know, keep it simple, stick to the basics until you're ready to go and attack a larger size garden again. Again, cut yourself some slack. Don't be too hard on yourself, all right? And that's what we're all here for, is to encourage you and give you a little bit of inspiration once again. Microgreens are also really easy to grow right now, or grow anytime indoors as well. So just take it easy on yourself for a little bit, okay? All right, we'll lead back into our number 4, which is our last little tip here to deal with garden burnout in just a moment. But let's, in the meantime, pop back to the chat. And here's Jules' gardening tips. I love that because our daughter's name is Jules, Julianne, but we call her Jules. So I wonder if that's your name as well. But anyway, nice to have you here. And good point. We keep our main herb station close to the kitchen, all in containers. I love that. It's great because then it's really easy access. You know, I marinate a lot of chicken for barbecuing, for grilling. So I squeeze lemon juice on it and then I pop outside, grab some rosemary and sage. And that's pretty much all I do to marinate my chicken. Or if you want a quick little snip of basil, a lot of times I'll make a cucumber basil salad for lunch, a cucumber tomato basil salad, and the basil is right here. I don't have to go down to the main garden. I just come and grab a little bit. Or greens if you want some for your smoothies or salads. It's a great thing to have things close to the house for easy access. Okay, Santa Ana Road Wild Man, thank you so much. He just smashed the like button. Appreciate that. Thank you for all of your support. And it's great to have you here again. And Santa Ana Road Wild Man is taking a break from work today. So I love it. Love that you're able to join us today. Okay, let's see if there's any other questions here. A lot of people saying it is hot. And Lori has a question here. Does heat slow down Swiss chard? You know, everything, when temperatures get like 95, 100, pretty much everything slows down. Now, Swiss chard can really, really take the heat. So usually it keeps ticking pretty well, but it definitely will slow down, like tomato, anything that flowers, like tomatoes, cucumbers. Watermelon does like the heat, does pretty well in super hot temperatures. Pepper, eggplant. A lot of times you'll see your flowers drying up or scorched leaves. That's perfectly normal in the heat. And we always talk about shade cloth here. If you haven't used shade cloth, you definitely want to check into that, because that could really help save your veggies in the heat. And that way you're not having to start all over again. But I say for the most part, Swiss chard does pretty well even in very hot temps. It might kind of wilt a little bit in the afternoon, just like a zucchini or squash and cucumbers do. It's kind of just a normal response to the heat, but it actually will do really, really well. In fact, I've got some right down here and it's actually not wilting at all. It looks great and it's probably 95 degrees out right now. Okay, Urban Chicken Mama, thank you so much. I like your sticky notes and your seed packets. Thank you. I usually do try and include, or I do include some type of a freebie with every single packet, whether it's a free seed packet or some type of bookmark, sticky note, pen. You never know what you're going to get. So it's always kind of like Christmas when you get an order in the mail from me. Okay, excuse me. Okay. So number 4, and this is probably one of the most important tips to avoiding or dealing with garden burnout, is accept what you can't change, okay? Sometimes that's a hard one because we do get emotionally invested in our gardens. We're very emotionally invested in plants that we started from seed. There's something about nurturing a plant for months, planting it outside, and then you just want so badly to be able to harvest from that and taste that amazing tomato or pepper or whatever special plant that you have planted from seed. And I just realized I missed a super chat. Oh my goodness, I just saw it up there at the top. Sorry that I missed that, and I'm not sure if I can pull that back up again. It's from Jay for $10. So thank you so much. Appreciate your support, and that's very, very kind of you to super chat $10. Really, really appreciate that. Okay, so accept what you can't change. And we kind of have to manage our expectations, right? Even from the start of the season, where things are going to happen in the garden. There's going to be challenges, right? If you think anyone has a perfect garden, no matter what you see on Instagram, no one does, right? There's always pests, diseases, heat. And I always try and, like on our garden tour we posted over the weekend, to show you guys those areas, because it'd be easy for me to completely clean up my garden and act like nothing's wrong. But you know what? That's not how it is for anyone. We all have issues that we're dealing with at one time or another during the season. Some of us a little bit more than others, but accept what you cannot change. If there is a plant that is just infested with spider mites, it's just the way it goes. You win some, you lose some. And the best thing you can do is just move on and start over with a new plant. Or if it's too late for that, well, there's always something you can grow. If it's too late for that particular tomato, start over with something else, right? And one reason I always like to have backups of some type of plant that I can then replant if something happens is because it helps you manage those expectations. Helps you avoid disappointment. It helps you, you know, not be crushed when something dies. Although, you know, we've all felt that way at one time or another, so I totally understand. But some things you just can't change. The heat, there's nothing we can do about that. So the best thing we can do is manage it and do our best to garden in times where it's not hot. I know my sister just moved to Florida last December, and she said in the summer it's really hard to garden because it's so hot. So, you know, a lot of people there, and if you're from Florida, please let me know, will plant their main gardens in the winter time. So, you know, right about now, maybe they're starting their seeds and getting ready to plant some warm weather veggies. So, you know, if that's you and you're in that type of a climate, then just roll with it, go with it, do what works for you in your area. If you haven't had a good gardening season, that's just the way it goes sometimes. And maybe you can start over with something indoors, or just realize that next season will be a fresh new season to start fresh with brand new plants. So you win some, you lose some. And here's camera guy back out here. He's so nice.
Good job.
To bring me some more water.
How's it going, everybody?
To make sure that I'm staying hydrated out here.
Yes, it's burning up out here like everyone else is.
It's burning up. And one reason I've been live streaming just here on the deck, because the house is right there and it's way too hot in the garden to bring everything down. So it's actually worked out really well. And that camera guy can pop out here and hang out and join us on the live streams. So maybe we'll answer a couple more questions. If anyone has a question for camera guy, let us know.
Okay.
Before I do that, I wanted to show you guys what we harvested yesterday. And you might have seen a picture on my Instagram. Like, there's more stuff in the house that just spread out one little basket, but the peppers were just amazing. A little poblano, that sunscald there, you can still eat that. Some jalapenos, which I was going to make poppers yesterday, but we had a really busy late evening in the garden while it was cool, so I didn't get around to making poppers, but hopefully Monday or Tuesday. Here we have Vanna, right? And then I love these cucumbers. I had to show you guys this really funny shape. This is a Japanese... thin cucumber, and look at the shape of that one. That's kind of interesting. And this one here looks really oversized, like it would be bitter. But I think I harvested one about twice as long, and I broke it in half, and it tasted delicious. So I think we're going to have this one for lunch if we can find some tomatoes to put with it.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Okay, so what questions do you all have? Good job, Vanna. John, lots of spider mites here, too. Mm-hmm. I totally get that. What I do is I spray off everything. Anytime I see bugs, I spray it off, clip the spider mite leaves, and then they don't like peppermint oil. So if you can spray with peppermint oil, they don't like the smell of that, and sometimes I'll take care of it. Okay, Sobal, we were fortunate enough to put up a tent during the heat wave days. Very, very smart. It's a good way to, of course, protect yourself if you're outside, but to protect your garden as well during those really hot days. And Carl has harvested one single cucumber from my plant so far. You know what, Carl? That's kind of hard sometimes, especially if you love cucumbers. And I was saying actually in the pre-chat, pre-live stream chat, some years are just kind of off for certain veggies. Last year I had like zero scallop squash, and this year we have an abundance. And I don't really see a real apparent reason for last year's, you might call it fail, but I don't call it that. It's just a learning experience. So some years are just off. If you can, if you have more time, plant some seeds. Plant more seeds, because right now they will grow fast, and maybe you can get some more out of it still before it gets too too cold. Okay, Ramona, yes, absolutely. Do you mix water or soap with a peppermint oil? You absolutely do. I have a video called Organic Pest Control. So search that on our channel. Just click on the magnifying glass and search Organic Pest Control. It'll give you the little recipe. You definitely do want to dilute it and put a little bit of soap in there, but the exact recipe is in the video. So definitely go back and check. And Cliff, I love Cliff's comment. There are so many things we just don't know. Absolutely. There's a lot we don't know. And it's one thing we can all learn from each other here and kind of experiment together. But sometimes life just happens. It's a circle of life. Okay, the healing berry. When will you film with your friend again and actually show him? The friend with the pizza oven and the funny car. That's great. We were actually just talking about that. So We'll have to let him know there's been some requests and maybe we can set something up with him.
Yes, I actually think that, I think we're getting to that point where we need to kind of start identifying him. And you know, he just shoots a lot with us. He's been a longtime friend of mine. Ours as well. So yeah, good call, Ranka. I think we'll definitely move in that direction.
Absolutely. Okay, Pony Girl, thank you very much. Kim, you always keep it real. Thank you. We try to.
Yeah.
Jules, what's the name of that cucumber you showed? It is a Japanese long cucumber, and these are quite prolific. I did just take the plant out because it was looking pretty ratty, but before I did, I harvested all these delicious cucumbers, so. Okay, Scout800A, thank you, Cliff, on Instagram. He does have an amazing vehicle that you will really enjoy seeing, so check him out on Instagram as well. Okay, guys, it's hot out here, so we're going to call the live stream. Do make sure you join us next week. A couple videos in between now and then, but next week at Monday, noon Pacific time. And don't forget, no live stream on Labor Day. And then head over to CallieKimGardenHome.com and get your seeds, guys, with the code GARDENFRESH for 20% off. All right, have a great week.
Jeff, good to see you here at the same time. For so many years, we've always just been hit and miss. So good to see you here.
Yeah, always good to see him.
All righty.
All right, guys, have a great week. Bye-bye.